Welcome back to our YouTube channel, Don Bosco School Tinsukia. Once again, we'll continue that arithmetic progression. We'll solve some problems based on arithmetic progression. Our question is, how many three digit numbers are divisible by 7? So we'll have to calculate how many three digit numbers are there which are divisible by 7. Let us solve it. So to find how many three digit numbers are there divisible by 7, at first we'll have to find the AP we'll have to make. So we have to find the first three digit number which is divisible by 7. So see how to find it. So first, what is the smallest three digit number? It is 100. Now let us divide 100 by 7. We are going to find the first or the smallest three digit number which is divisible by 7. For that, we have taken the smallest three digit number which is 100 and we'll divide it now by 7. So two digits we'll have to take at a time. At first, upon 10, 7 will go one time, 7 1 is 7, then 10 minus 7 gives 3, next 0 will come down, 30, upon 30, 7 will go 4 times, 28, remainder is 2, 2 is remainder. That means 100 it is not divisible by 7 because there is remainder 2. So what is the first three digit number which is divisible by 7? To find that, we'll have to add the difference between this remainder and the divisor to this dividend. Let me to repeat it once again. To find the smallest three digit number which is divisible by 7, we'll have to find the sum of this dividend and the difference between this divisor and the remainder. So what is the difference between this 7 and 2? It will be 5. That means 5 will have to add to 100. So smallest number is how much? Smallest number equal to, we'll get this 100 dividend plus difference between divisor and remainder. So 7 minus 2, which will give us 105. 7 minus 2 will give us 5. 5 plus 100 will give us 105. So our AP is, first number is 105. 105, it is the smallest three digit number which is divisible by 7. Now to find the next number, we can just go on adding 7. So 105 plus 7, that will give 112. 112 plus 7, that will give 119, dot dot dot. Then the last one we'll have to find once again. What will be the last or the greatest three digit number which is divisible by 7? For this, we'll have to recall the greatest three digit number. What is the greatest three digit number? The greatest three digit number is 999. But we are going to find the greatest three digit number which is divisible by 7. This is the greatest three digit number, but we need to find the greatest three digit number which is divisible by 7. So 999, like earlier, once again we will divide it by 7. So one digit, 9, upon 9, 7 will go one time, 7, 9 minus 7, 2, next 9 will come down, 29, upon 29, 7 will go 4 times, it is 28, 9 minus 8, 1, 9, upon 19, 7 will go 2 times, 7, 2, 14, now remainder 5. Now, to find the greatest 3 digit number which is divisible by 7, we will have to subtract this remainder. Little difference from finding this smallest 3 digit number which is divisible by 7. So this time simply we have to subtract this remainder from the greatest 3 digit number. That itself will give us the greatest 3 digit number which is divisible by 7. So we will get greatest on, greatest number equal to, we will get 999. 999 minus 5, that gives us 994. So the last number is 994. So we have got the AP. Now very easily we can calculate how many like these three digit numbers are there which are divisible by 7. So here A equal to how much? A equal to, A means the first term. So in this series, A is 105. A is 105. D how much? 112 minus 105, if we do, that will give us 7. So D is 7. And N we are going to find. And the last term of the AP is how much? 994. So An equal to 994. Nth term is 994. So we are given these three things: A's value we are given D's value, we are given An's value. Using these three values, we'll have to calculate Nth value. So like earlier, we'll write that formula for finding Nth term of an AP. Let me do it. Is we know that A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to An. Here also An we have written in right hand side, just for our convenience. Now looking at here, we'll substitute the values. So A means 105 plus N. Do you know the value of N? No. In fact, we are asked to find the value of N. So N will remain as it is. So N, then minus 1 also will remain same in its own place. And D's value is known to us. How much it is? It is 7. So in place of D, we'll write now 7 equal to An. Do you know the value of An? Yes, it is 994. Now just we'll solve it. At first we will send this 105 to right hand side. This N minus 1 into 7, keep it same, is equal to 994 minus 105. So N minus 1, just keep it same, into 7 equal to subtract 14 minus 5, that will give 889. Next, 7 is related to N minus 1 by the operation of multiplication here. So when 7 will go to other side, it will become division. So N minus 1, let it be same in its own place. Bracket is not required now. We can just drop the bracket. Just N minus 1 equal to 889 whole thing divided by 7. Now cancellation will do. 889 by 7, 7 1 7, 7 minus 8 1, 8 will come down, 7 2 0 14, 8 minus 4 4 9, 7 7 7 0 49 over. So 889 by 7, if we do cancellation, that will give us 127. This implies N minus 1 equal to, we are left with 127. Finally, minus 1, after changing the side, it will become plus 1. And we'll get N equal to 127 plus 1, which gives 128. So, N's value is 128. And in question, we are asked how many 3-digit numbers are divisible by 7. So, our answer will be, therefore, the required number of 3-digit numbers divisible by 7 is 128. Like that, one conclusion we can write. Therefore, the required number of three digit numbers divisible by seven is equal to 128, which is our answer. So there are 128 numbers, 3-digit numbers, which are divisible by 7. We'll move to another question. We'll take some more example. Let me to erase it. The sum of the sum of first n terms, in fact it is a formula only, the sum of first n terms of an AP is given by the sum of first n terms of an AP is given by S is equal to n by 2 into twice A plus n minus 1 into D. So this is another formula actually, the sum of first n terms of an AP is given by S is equal to n by 2 into twice A plus n minus 1 into D. So where n means term number, A means the first term and D means common difference. Like previous formula, here also A means first term, D means common difference and n means term number. And there is another formula, this is one, and another one it is written as S is equal to n by 2, n by 2 into A plus n. So these two formulas can be used for finding the sum. Sometimes we will use this first one and sometimes we will use this second term, where S is equal to n by 2 into A plus an. Depending upon the availability of things, what things are available to us, we will choose the formula which one to use and when to use which one. So sometimes we will use S is equal to n by 2 into twice A plus n minus 1 into D, and some other time we will use S is equal to n by 2 into A plus an. So far three formula we have got, in fact four. If you saw my previous video, there you can see that the general form of an AP, we got there A into A comma A plus D comma A plus 2D comma dot dot dot, that first formula. Then second one, the formula for finding nth term of an AP, which is given by n equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Then third one is this, for finding the sum. If we are given some AP, in that case, to find the sum of all the numbers of that AP, we have to use this formula, that S is equal to n by 2 into twice A plus n minus 1 into D, or we can use this formula also, S is equal to n by 2 into A plus an. So when to use which one, that depends upon the availability of things in the questions. If we are given this n's value, we are given A's value, we are given D's value, in that case we can use this first formula. But if we are given the values of an and n's value, then we can go for this second formula. Now we'll take one example and we'll solve that problem by using this formula. Let me to write the question. So question is, find the sum of the following AP. Find the sum of the following APs. Number one, it is 2 comma 7 comma 12 comma dot 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 to 10th terms. 10th terms. Let us solve it, then second question I will take. So we are given the AP as 2, 7, 12, dot 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 to 10th term. We will have to find the sum of this. So here A equal to how much? 2. D equal to how much? D means second term minus first term. So 7 minus 2, that will give us 5. And N, 10th term. So N's value is how much? 10. N equal to 10. We'll find S. So we know that formula will write, S is equal to n by 2 into twice A plus n minus 1 into D. Sometimes this S can also be written as SN. In place of S, it is written as SN. So whether it is written S or SN, matter is same. So you are not required to worry about it, whether SN written or S written, same thing. So S is equal to n by 2 into twice A plus n minus 1 into D. Just looking it up, we will substitute the values now. So n is our how much? N. We are going to find the sum of the following APs. So till 10th term given, that means our n is 10. So in place of n, 10 by 2, then 2 into A. A how much? A is once again 2 plus n minus 1. So n, just now we have used, it is 10. So 10 minus 1 into D. D is 5. So 10 by 2, that will give us 5. Then here 2 to 4 plus 10 minus 1, that will give us 9, and 9 5 jar, that will give us 45. Now this is equal to 5, let it remain in its own place, into 4 plus 45, 45 plus 4, that will give us 49, then 49 into 5, so 9, 5 jar, 45, 4 carry, 5, 4 jar 20 plus 4, 24, so which is our answer, so 245, sum of all these terms till 10th term will give us 245. Last one more question we'll discuss and then we'll stop our class today. Second question is, same question, find the sum of the following APs, but this time you see, you will able to understand the difference. It is given 34 plus 32 plus 30 plus dot 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 plus 10. Now if you compare this question with previous question, you will see there it was written 10th term. It was written there 10th term, but this time it is not written 10th term, but it is written as plus 10. This means here an's value itself is 10. An's value is 10. It is not the n's value, but it is an's value. So let us find the things. So a equal to how much? What is the first term? It is 34. So a equal to 34. D, how to find D? D, to find D, second term minus first term we will have to do. Always second term minus first term. One more thing you have to remember, that D, it is not necessary that all the time D's value will get positive. We may get D's value as negative also. So it hardly any matter whether we are getting positive or negative. To find D, just you will remember that second term minus first term will do. What I told? To find D, we will have to subtract first term from second term, not second term from first term. So D equal to, here second term is how much? 32, and first term is 34. So D equal to 32 minus 34. How much shall we get? 32 minus 34, that will give us minus 2. So D we have got minus 2, and AN. AN equal to how much? AN equal to 10. AN equal to 10. So here you see, we are given A's value, we are given AN's value. With this and this value also we are given. Using this information, are we in that position to apply any one of those two formulae which we have got so far for finding the sum of an AP? Try to recall that our formula is S is equal to, one formula is N by 2 into twice A plus N minus 1 into D, and the other one is S is equal to N by 2 into A plus AN. S is equal to N by 2 into A plus AN. Look here, to apply this formula, are all the things available or not? We know A's value. A's value is known to us. We know D's value. D's value is also known to us. But N's value. Are we given here N's value? N's value is missing. So we cannot use here. Directly we cannot use this formula. Let's try whether this formula is applicable or not. Same problem is arising. Here also there is N, but we don't know N. So our first work is to find the value of n by using the very second formula which we got for finding the nth term of an AP. We will get the value of n, and after that we will be in that position to apply any one of these two formulae. So let's find n at first. So we know that an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to an. Once again an I have written in right hand side. So let's put the values, whatever available, A means our 34 plus N we don't know, in fact we are going to find D, how much? D it is minus 2, since the value of D is negative, so we'll have to keep it inside bracket. So minus 2, like this we have to write, don't write without bracket, then it will give another meaning and the thing will become wrong. So we'll have to write within bracket minus 2 is equal to AN. Do you know AN? How much? It is 10, so AN equal to 10. So our first work will be to send this 34 to right hand side. 34 after going to right hand side, it will become minus 34. So this implies n minus 1 minus 2 let us write at first, then into n minus 1. If we write minus 2 in the very beginning, then without bracket also we can write, it will give the same meaning. So minus 2 into n minus 1 is equal to 10, right hand side is 10, it will remain same in its own place, and this 34 after changing side it will become minus 34. So 10 minus 34. So minus 2 into n minus 1 is equal to 10 minus 34, that will give us minus 24. Minus 24, minus sign will cancel from both sides, then n minus 1 will keep alone in left hand side, and 2 on sending right hand side, it will become the denominator. So 24 by 2. This implies n minus 1 equal to 24 by 2, that will give us 12. Finally, minus 1, when will it will go to right hand side, it will become plus 1 and we will get n equal to 13. So n equal to 13. Once we have got the value of n, then we can use any one of these two formula, any one. It will be easier for us if we use the second one here, because we know a. A is how much? Here a equal to how much? If I am not wrong, it is 34. A equal to 34 and an. An is the last term, which is 10, and n. N is how much? 13. So using these three things, we can find. So therefore, s equal to the second one we can use. First one also can be used, but now I am going to use second one. Therefore, s is equal to formula, second one, n by 2 into a plus an. That is s. How many terms sum are we going to find? What is the value of n? It is 13. So we are going to find 13 terms sum. So it can be written as s 13 also, or simply we can write s. Both are same thing. As I have already told, here sometimes we will write as s only, and some other times we write sn also. Same matter, whether it is written as s or it is written as sn. So thinking that here there is n, we can write here s 13, otherwise we can simply write s is equal to. So n, n is how much? What is the value of n? 13. So it is 13 by 2 into a. A how much? A is 34, first term of the AP, it is 34, plus the last term of the AP. Last term of the AP how much? Last term of the AP is 10. 13 by 2, cancellation not possible, let it remain like this. 34 plus 10, 44, 222 are 44. Finally, 22 into 13, 22 into 13. 3 2 6 2 1 2 3 2 6 2 1 2 and then 6 2 6 8 2 286. So sum of all the terms of this AP is how much? 286. So I hope you have understood, you have got ideas about APs. Thanks for watching our channel. We'll meet once again very soon.